Today, we're going to be talking about the fastest ways that you can increase your power in Infinity Kingdom. What's going on, guys? Cheers! Now, if you've played any sort of war strategy game before, you're probably familiar with the power system. Typically, it's in the top left corner, and that power goes up as you progress your account, your city, your whatever the case might be. Well, this is no different in Infinity Kingdom, except that there are two really meaningful measures of your power. There is your total account power in the top left, and there's also the troop power, which you can see here in the troop screen. Both of these are incredibly important for different reasons, but I will say right at the beginning of this video that what is most important is your troop power in Infinity Kingdom, specifically concentrated into a single march, and we're going to talk about that in a little bit. Your troop power reflects the ability for that march to actually deal damage to other marches in the open field, when you're hitting cities, things along those lines. Also, when you have these troops on your garrison, for example, how successful that will be will depend on how powerful your troops are. Same thing with the arena. You know, if you keep losing the arena, then it may be because your armies just don't have enough power for that troop power statistic. When we look at the total power for your account here, you can see my highest power here, and it breaks it down. There's a couple of things that are important here. Your total power is built up of your immortal power, building power, dragon power, technology power, your troop power, and it doesn't actually take into consideration, apparently, the fortifications on your wall. You can see here my troop power does not move. If I speed this up entirely, boom, I got 36,000 caltrops and it doesn't move an inch. So with your overall power being a combination of many different things, it's important to think about how can you boost that power quickly, right? Well, first thing that I'll say is that it's not necessarily important to have a really high total power number. Now, if you're experienced with Infinity Kingdom, you may say, hey, Omniarch, troop power is really the only thing that matters because that's what decides whether or not you win fights, which to an extent is true, but you also have to keep in mind that as your account progresses, you are going to be increasing the level of your castle, which is going to increase the level of your Tower of Knowledge. And so in general, a higher total power is going to indicate farther progression into the game, and farther progression is going to unlock more skills. It's going to unlock more technology in the academy. It's going to give you higher tiers of troops when you upgrade your barracks for the different troop types. So that's important to keep in mind, right? So while it's true that troop power is really what decides battles, your total power is going to give you an idea of how far is that player really into the game. So, okay, we've established that total power and troop power are both very important. So let's talk a little bit about how do you increase these numbers, right? Well, again, your total power is built up of a ton of different things. And this is going to be a little bit of a spoiler here. If you take a look at my power statistics, you can see that an overwhelming majority of my power comes from my immortals. That's right, your immortals, this is more than half of my power, comes from immortals alone. And in fact, you look at buildings and technology, you would think that those would be the most important for the power of your city, of your castle, right? Because, you know, that's sort of what's giving you all of the stats. If you look at the academy, the research is where you're getting a ton of your attack stats, your defense stats, things like that, when you come into the technology. But in fact, if we look at something like Lead the Charge, for example, if I go ahead and complete this, I'm only going to get like 150 power from completing this level 8 to level 9 leading the charge, which, you know, just so you guys are aware, this is over a day of research time in order to complete this. It also requires a lot of resources. So pushing your buildings and your academy, while it does give you a lot of benefits when it comes to fighting, it's not really going to give you a very good return on your total power. So again, this total power is a little bit deceptive, right? Because all the progress that I've made really isn't reflected as much in this number as my immortals are, right? Now, you also may be looking at my troop power and saying, well, troop power is a really big percentage of that too. And that is also true. Your troop power is very important for the total power of your castle and of your city. However, unlike the other forms of power in the game, troop power can be diminished, meaning if your city gets, you know, zeroed, for example, you lose a nice little chunk of troop power. If your training grounds gets depleted all the way down to zero, well, you know, no troops means no troop power. So while that is a great way to increase the power, total power of your city, it's going to require a lot of resources and speed ups, just like with building, and you may get an actually a better return on your speed up and resource investment. But keep in mind that that can be erased if you are attacked or you're constantly fighting, whereas, you know, buildings and technology, not really going to go away. So again, if you're pushing, Like, if you're in an event or if you need to reach a certain power level for whatever reason, if you're pushing, then going for troop power is definitely going to be a better return than going for building or technology power, even though, you know, from a perspective of effectiveness, you need buildings and technology to do well in war, right? So again, we're not talking about what's going to make you the strongest player in the game. We're talking about what's going to make this number the biggest, okay? So training tons of troops. Now, this also has a cap, which is the sort of unfortunate part. The training grounds do have a limit to the number of troops that you can have within your city, within your castle. So the capacity is going to be the limiting factor here for how much troop power you can really have. Now, one thing that's actually not shown here is your dragon power, and I'm not sure if they sort of factor that into maybe your immortal power, but dragons do make a nice little chunk of power, right? If we take a look at your troops here, you can see that this is 98,000. If we remove my water dragon here, it goes down to 86,000. So about 12,000 power just from my water dragon alone, which is really nice. Of course, that effect is diminished significantly. If we take a look at something like my fire dragon here, it's about 8,000 power. But if we take a look at my wind dragon, which is my weakest, it's about 3,000 power. So, you know, there is a nice amount of power that you get from your dragon. Again, I don't know if that's calculated as a mortal power here, but keep in mind that upgrading your dragon is also a nice way to increase your power. However, there's also a cap here, and this does get pretty expensive, right? This isn't as easy as like training troops, for example. You do need to get, you know, crystals for these dragons and things along those lines, so it does become pretty difficult to do it in that way. But always keep in mind that dragons are powerful as well, as they should be. I mean, just look at them, man. Just look at these dragons. This is so cool, these animations, and these it's amazing. All right, so that brings us to immortals themselves, and this is where you're going to be getting the most amount of your power. I mean, you can see here Merlin for me is 25,000 power, and remember, if we're looking at a single technology, it gives you 150. This immortal alone gives you 25,000. It's night and day. Immortals are by far the best way. If you're rushing power, if you just want to see a huge jump in that number to get into an alliance or whatever reason you have, that's the way to go. You want to focus on your immortals. Now, getting these immortals to some of these higher levels, level 39, for example, level 40, maxing them out, there is diminishing returns, and it becomes really expensive when you start to reach those higher levels. So there are a couple of things that you can do. One little trick that you can do, and I think other YouTubers and also other people I've seen on Discord have mentioned this as well, is you can sort of just bring all of your low level immortals to around level 10 to 20, somewhere in there, and the you know, just getting this level up, 10 experience points, like, that is such a small investment. You can even do this by just defeating gnomes out, you know, using your action points and things like that. It's super easy to level these up. So let me give you guys an example here, okay? This immortal power, Mulan, is 4,500 just by having her, right? Like, that's more than a ton of technology in itself, just by having Mulan. But if we go ahead and level her up, let's go ahead and see, actually, let's do this with an immortal that I think I may actually use in the future. Okay, let's go with Ashoka. He's level 1, and we haven't done any sort of boosting on him yet at all, okay? So we see 5,800 power. Let's go ahead and bring him up to level 15. So keep an eye on how many experience points it takes. Level 2 is 20. Level 3 is 80. Like, this is nothing. This is super cheap. It's not even, it doesn't even cost 1,000 yet to get him up to level. So here, now that he's level 10, that's when it breaks the 1,000 XP mark for a single level. But even still, like, this is still a really relatively low amount of experience. Once you hit 15, I think that's a good stopping point, right? Because now you're talking about 11,000 experience per level. If we take a look at somebody like, I guess we'll go back to Mulan just because she's cool, okay? Let's bring her up and we'll see. It looks like it's taking a similar amount of experience. Yeah, actually, it looks like it's an identical amount. And yeah, it is. So there we go. So we've got Mulan a little bit higher. So yeah, it's the same amount of experience, actually. So you might as well do this with some of your rarest immortals, because they're going to be the most powerful base anyway. So we've got Ashoka to 15, right? And you can see his power went up to 7,100. And that was just a few seconds. It didn't take that much experience, right? Now let's go ahead and boost him. And I have a lot of these items that you need. I can spend a lot of this stuff because I've just been saving it over time. So let's go ahead and boost him up, see how high we can go. Okay, now this does cost gold, but in general it's not going to cost you too much, right? The first one was less than 300. Now we're talking about 900 gold. Nothing crazy here. This is becoming more and more powerful. You can see 69 power right there just for spending a little bit of gold. We're going to keep going ahead and we're going to do this and we're going to just boost him up to maybe plus 10 or something like that. I think that's a reasonable place to stop. This is a immortal that I will probably be using in my Fire March anyway. So you can see here that the gold cost is starting to increase pretty substantially. It's getting up there for sure. But we're going to keep going. We're going to keep boosting him. We're going to see how high we can bring him because again, he is somebody that you can invest or that I'm going to be investing in. So boom, we got him up to 10 and now he's about 9,000 power, but it doesn't stop there because I have equipment on my Ashoka. Okay. So my equipment here is also important. Let's go ahead and strengthen all of these up to 15. Let's go ahead and do that. So we'll do 5, 10, 15, 5, 10, 15, 5, 10, 15. And this is going to bring us with the resonance levels. That's important. Those are milestones that you want to reach. So we bring this up to 15 and now we're up to 9,500. Getting these to 15 really doesn't cost that much. I mean, look, to get it to 16, it costs 200 stones. Like it's really a cheap investment. Right. And you saw that the power went up there by a few thousand, which is insane. So we can actually go ahead and do that for multiple immortals. I mean, if we take a look here, my power has gone up nicely, which is really great. And this is the best and cheapest way to sort of rush power. Like if you want to have a really quick jump in power, this is the best way to do it. Just make small investments, incremental investments into a lot of different immortals, and you're going to see that total power increase. Now, again, this is not going to reflect your ability to win battles, right? Because if you're doing this with immortals that you're not really going to be using too much, well, then, you know, you're sort of boosting that sort of empty power, right? Because you're not getting much of it use out of them. They're not very strong. So it is what it is. I don't think that, you know, having empty power is necessarily good. But again, you know, the point of this video is to get power quickly and we can go ahead and do that here with Empress Wu. So we're going to go ahead and level up her to level 15. We're doing the same thing again, just to give you guys another example of you know, how lucrative this actually is if you're trying to jump power quickly. So we got that to 10, we got her to 15. Let's go ahead and strengthen her equipment as well. Boom, boom, boom. And yeah, this is pretty much it. If you, again, you don't need that much in order to do this in terms of experience, and it's pretty quick. I mean, it literally just takes a couple of minutes. You can save all of this stuff for a particular moment in time where you really want to push power all at once. So you can sort of hoard the items that you need in order to increase the boost level. You can hoard your experience scrolls. You can hoard your stones to increase the level of the equipment. There's a lot of things you can do to plan for a giant push. And you can do this for a bunch of different immortals. Now, I know what you're thinking, right? You're thinking Omniarch, you know, you said that this is sort of empty power. So what's the whole point here, right? Well, the point is that later down the line, you can actually go into the alchemy lab and you can reborn the immortals that you've done this to that you're not really going to use, right? So I can go in here and let's take a look at, well, Mulan's not really somebody that I'm super interested in. So I can go ahead and reborn her and I'm going to get back all of her soul fragments, right? Which is nice. The fragments for turning into soul crystals. That's going to be cool. I get my gold back. I get my experience back. Let's go ahead and do it. We're going to get rid of her. There is a cooldown to do this, obviously. So later down the line, you're going to have to slowly build this back up and redistribute that power to the immortals that actually move the needle for you and make a significant amount of difference. So remember, if you do this strategy in the early game and distribute your power amongst a bunch of different immortals, over time, you do want to reborn them and put all of that energy and experience into a single one or two of your strongest troops. Here you can see I've sort of done that with my Water March, and then I've been slowly doing that with these other two marches as well. And that's really it. Just focus on your immortals, and it's a low investment for a high return on total power. And of course, obviously, you're going to have a higher troop power because you're focusing on just immortals. So this is a way to increase both of those numbers at the same time, and it's pretty straightforward. With that being said, guys, if you found this video useful or entertaining or informative or anything like that, drop a thumbs up on it. It really helps out the channel a ton. It helps get this video out into the YouTube algorithm so other Infinity Kingdom players might see it. Also, if you're new around here, subscribe to the channel and click that bell to be notified the next time that I upload an Infinity Kingdom video. If you haven't played Infinity Kingdom yet, there's a link in the description below to download the game. It's absolutely free to play. It supports the channel, and I think it's worth giving a try. Guys, if you have any suggestions on how you can jump in power really quickly, put it in the comment section below. I would love to hear your strategies. I'm always learning. I'm always trying to find the best ways to do things in Infinity Kingdom. And as always, my social media links, they're in the description. Make sure you follow me over on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Discord, all that stuff. It's always down below. And with that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. This has been Omniarch. I will talk to you guys again soon. Peace.